Hey guys, Gavin here. Yesterday on the Rabbits and Colonies forum, somebody was asking about fodder systems, and yesterday was the day that I started getting my fodder system up for the year. Where I live, it gets too cold in the winter time, and if I brought it inside, I guess I could do it all year long, but I close it down for the winter time. But now that it's spring, I've got it going. So I'm just gonna show you what it looks like. It's an empty system right now, but this is where I start. Indoors, I do these little quart jars. They're wide mouth quart jars. I have a little screen on them. And what I do is the first day for 12 hours, I soak my seeds. This is my second day's one, so it's in the middle of soaking. And I do wheat because that's what is available cheaply out here. This is my stock of organic feed grade wheat. I just keep this in my kitchen, and I've made a little funnel, and I put a cup of seeds into my quart jar. And like I said, I soak it for about 12 hours, then I pour it out, and the next day inside, I will get it wet a couple of times. Tomorrow I'll pour this out and do the same thing with it, and tomorrow I'll put this into my fodder system, so I'll have an empty jar. I'll start the cycle all over again. So basically I do 2 days inside my house. Then I'm gonna show you the fodder system, which is right outside the back door here. You see my colony is out there. This is my fodder system. Let me back up so you can see the whole thing. Now, when I first started doing wheat fodder, I've done barley fodder as well, but when I first started, I had a reservoir down at the bottom of my system that would recycle water up into my system. And actually what I found is I was using more water than I am now. So let me just show you how it works. I have a 5 gallon bucket full of water. I go through about 2 gallons of water a day doing this. That water gets pumped up to the top, where it comes out of these little spouts right here. Nothing pretty about it. And then what I have, this is the key to a good fodder system, is the tray that you use. At least that's my experience. I've tried lots of different trays, but I finally found this tray on Amazon. It's made by a company named, I think it's called Carlisle. This is the AR22. And it basically is like a deli tray. It's made out of fiberglass. And, you know, black fiberglass is very slick, very easy to clean. And then down here at the bottom, I've made several, I think they are 4 millimeter holes. And so the water comes down here, goes down, drains, goes to the next tray, and it just follows. And you'll see that there are 6 trays. My doggy wants to get out of the way there. So those 6 trays are basically every day I get a tray of wheat fodder, because it's about a 6 day cycle once it gets out here. So that is the system. Now, maybe your question is going to be, well, how often should I water? Now, it's going to depend on your climate, but this is what I do. And when I started, I overwatered a lot and I got a lot of mold. And it was a combination of overwatering and the trays that I was using. The trays would hold the water in them and it would just mold out. So what I do is I have this timer that is set for 8 a.m. You can see that the trays are wet right now because 45 minutes ago, and you can see how it's come out down here. About 45 minutes ago, it turned on. It goes on for 1 minute. At 8 a.m., at 2 p.m., at 8 p.m., and 2 a.m. And that 1 minute, 4 times a day, is enough to water all of my seeds, and then it uses about 2 gallons in that day. It's about 1/2 gallon each time it does that. And like I said, I used to cycle it, but what happens is the water gets rancid, and you have to replace it every day anyway, and so I was replacing about 5 gallons of water a day. And now I'm about 2 gallons. So that is the system. Hope you enjoy it.